We are in the Inglewood neighborhood at the intersection of 63rd and Wallace. This is where the notorious serial killer H.H. Holmes building would have stood at one point. What's here now is the Inglewood Post Office. Back in Holmes' days, it was actually called the Inglewood Flats. The building would have been more on this little grassy knoll area right back here behind me. It would have encompassed maybe a portion of the post office, would have gone more over that way, been right on the corner of 63rd and Wallace. Now, we do not know exactly how many people H.H. Holmes killed in this building. It does become known as his murder castle. He does eventually put a third floor on the building, eventually billing it as the World's Fair Hotel, where they say that the hotel rooms, you could not lock them from the inside of the room. They could only be locked from the outside. Everything back in those days was lit with gas lamps. The connections to those gas lamps were outside the room. So again, you could be locked in a room and the gas turned off and you could be slowly gassed to death. The building did have a lot of strange oddities to it when it was built. There were doors that led to nothing. There were stairwells that went up to nowhere. There were closed off and hidden rooms throughout the building. Stories say that there's parts of the walls would have moved and there were like some chutes that led down into the basement. Some say there could have possibly been a crematorium down in the basement, which could have been used to dissect bodies. As it eventually becomes his murder castle, and we don't really know exactly how many people may have been killed here. The third floor he did bill as the World's Fair Hotel. Don't really know how many people actually stayed in the hotel during the World's Fair, if any really stayed there. There are estimates, some say that he killed as many as 200 people. There were at least 9 or 10 people that we know were last seen with Holmes, several of them who would have been last seen in this building, who in most cases their remains were never found again. He's actually only convicted of one murder, and that is the murder of his business partner, Ben Peitzel. That and Peitzel's three kids were the only bodies ever found connected to this man. Now, as far as ghost stories go, many people tell me that the basement of the building, a lot of the workers at the post office, say the basement of the building can be very creepy. They've heard sounds down there or seen shadow figures down there. There is a portion of the basement of the current building where it crosses over to a section that would be underneath the grassy knoll section right here, which looks much older. And many people believe that that section of the basement is or would have been part of the original basement from H.H. Holmes' murder castle when it existed here.